Suppose that you are asked to write down an arbitrary 3x3 invertible matrix whose inverse matrix is not obvious. What would you do? Clearly, you can look up an example in the book or on the internet. You could also try to write down an arbitrary 3x3 matrix and then see if it has an inverse. But these methods don't seem very effective. We now look at a way to generate invertible matrices using the following result. Let F denote a field, let n be a positive integer. Then, an n by n matrix A with entries in F is invertible if and only if A can be written as a product of elementary matrices. So with this result, we can easily come up with an n by n invertible matrix. You just start with an elementary matrix and then perform elementary row operations to it. And we can stop whenever we want. The reason is that multiplying a matrix by elementary matrices is equivalent to performing elementary row operations. So for example, if I start with this elementary matrix, I can say add 2 times row 1 to row 2, and then multiply row 1 by 3. This will be an invertible matrix. Now what's interesting about this result is that if you are given an invertible matrix, you can write it as a product of elementary matrices. So how do you come up with this product? The idea is as follows. Remember that when we are trying to find the inverse of A, we first form this augmented matrix. So if A is n by n, we append to the right the n by n identity matrix. We then perform elementary row operations until we get down to something that looks like this. Because we are performing elementary row operations, there exist elementary matrices M1 up to MK such that MK times MK minus 1 down to M1 times this matrix is precisely this matrix. Now, what this means is this product times A will give us the identity matrix, so this IN, and this product times the n by m identity matrix will be precisely A inverse. So we can write down A inverse is equal to mk times all the way down to m1. But A is the same as the inverse of A inverse, so this is precisely the inverse of this product. And this can be rewritten as the inverse of m1 times all the way up to the inverse of mk. Notice that the order is now reversed because of the property of the inverse of a product. So let's look at an example to see how we can make use of this. So suppose that my matrix A is 2, 2, 1, 2. Now notice that we don't really have to form this matrix. All we need to know is a sequence of elementary row operations that brings A to the identity matrix. And these matrices will depend on only the operations that we have used. So if I start off with this matrix and interchange rows 1 and 2, I get this. And if I subtract 2 times row 1 from row 2, I get this. And if I add row 2 to row 1, I get this. And finally, if I multiply row 2 by negative 1/2, I'll get the identity matrix. So we can write A as the inverse of the elementary matrix corresponding to the first operation. So in this case, it's interchanging row 1 and row 2. The elementary matrix for that is 0, 1, 1, 0. And the second matrix is the inverse of the elementary matrix corresponds to this operation here, and that is 1, 0, minus 2, 1. And the third operation will give us this matrix. And finally, the last matrix is this. So these are inverses, but inverses of elementary matrices are easy to form. So for this, the inverse is just itself. And for this matrix, we just turn the negative 2 to a 2. And for this matrix, we turn this 1 to a negative 1. And finally, we turn this negative 1/2 to negative 2. And you can check that this product does give you this matrix here.